Hey everyone, what is DNS? Have you ever wondered how you access the web pages that you do almost every other day? I am Pooja from IBM team, and I'm going to explain to you how DNS works. DNS, in short, is called the domain name system. The domain name system translates domain names to IP addresses. And what is a domain and what is an IP address? Let's take a look at them. First, let's see what a domain name is. A domain name is any text or string that you basically enter in your web page. It could be ibm.com, google.com, abc.com, any of these. What really is an IP address? IP address is a forset number. It goes like this. Just going to write a random number for you here. I'm pretty sure you have all seen this IP address almost every day when you access these websites and says, oh, you know your web browser is down. You know you're not able to access the DNS that you're looking for. So let's take an example, abc.com. What happens is, instead of typing abc.com, if you type in the IP address of that particular website in your web browser, you will actually be routed to the web page. Now, the main component of the DNS system is the DNS Resolver. So the DNS Resolver acts as the phone book in this entire thing. How do we bridge the gap between the human communication and the DNS and the networking world? So in the networking world, the computers use numbers to communicate with each other. And in the human world, we use names to communicate with each other. And here, DNS Resolver acts as a phone book where you search the name and match it to the number. The IP address is the internet protocol that has a set of rules that helps millions of devices communicate with each other. And that's why we have these IP addresses allocated to each and every device on the internet. All these devices communicate using this unique identifier. And since, as humans, we are not accustomed to remembering names, we use these domain names. To remembering numbers, we use the domain names. And that's how we resolve using the DNS Resolver. Now that we know an overview of the domain name system, let's take a look at how the DNS lookup happens. So the first step in the DNS lookup is the user. This is where we enter the website address from our web page. And you are going to be the actor here. So the web browser has what we call the cache memory. The cache memory stores certain values for a certain time period of time. So when you enter the address abc.com, let's say, what happens is it looks in the cache memory first. And when we say, oh, I don't have the IP address of the particular website that you're looking for, we forward the request to the main DNS resolver. So this is going to be our DNS resolver for the day. And now, from here, the DNS resolver has its own cache. It looks at its cache and says, hey, I don't have the IP address of the particular website that you're looking for. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to route your request to the root server. I'm going to use a different color. So this is the root server. And root server is the top server or the top level in the DNS hierarchy. And the root server still doesn't have the information of abc.com that you're looking for. But what it does have is the information about the top-level domain server that you have to route your request to. Also, the root server is placed across different locations throughout the world. There are almost hundreds of these root servers placed, and there are 12 different organizations that manage these root servers. And from there, we get the top-level domain server's IP address. So now we send the request to the TLD server. And the TLD is nothing but top-level domain, which basically means it has all the information for the top-level domain. And in this case, the top-level domain is going to be your .com. So it could be anything like .net, .org as such. What it does say is, hey, I don't have the IP address of abc.com, but I can send your request to the authoritative name server. I can send the IP address to which you need to send your request to. And the authoritative name server has all the information and all the DNS records that we need to access. So basically, the authoritative name server renders the DNS records that we need to access. So the request is sent to the auth name server. Oh, and we can also call it as the domain name server. And a lot of cloud providers across all over the world provide this server ability, and you can use multitude of them. So this is going to be your authoritative name server. And what the authoritative name server does, it sends back the IP address of the particular website that we are looking for. And now we get the IP address back to the DNS resolver. So the DNS resolver now stores it in the cache. I store it in the cache and I send it back to the web browser. And now the web browser has the IP address that it was looking for. What it does is it sends the request to the particular web server that points in the IP address that's being sent. So this is the web server of any particular website that you're probably accessing. In this case, it is going to be abc.com. So now the web server has all the content that is needed to display in your web page. What we render back is the content of your web page. This is the entire working of our DNS lookup. And this is what we almost do in every day when we access different websites all over the internet. I hope you find this video very informative. If you like this video and want to see more like it, please like and subscribe. If you have questions, please drop them in the comments below. Also, if you need to learn more about the DNS services, please visit our website for the domain name system services.